In this video, we are going to configure an instance of Pi interface for OPCDA. So to do this, let's go to the Pi interface node, namely Pi int 1. Now, before we begin, I would like to mention that as a best practice, we need to change the so-called protocol order. So what is protocol order? So to do this, let's go to start, all programs, Pi system, and choose about Pi SDK. Go to connections and select options. In here, you will note there is something called a protocol order. Note the protocol order is currently Windows Integrated Security followed by Pi Trust. Let's accept it by saying OK, and we are good. We can close about Pi SDK. Now let's start configuring the instance of Pi interface for OPCDA. To do this, let's go back again to start, all programs, Pi system, and now let's choose Pi interface configuration utility. Click on the open button to create the new instance from a batch file. It'll automatically navigate you to the 32-bit Pi PC folder, and if I go to the interface folder, I see the folder called OPC int. Here, let's select this batch file, which is called opcint.bat_new. This is the sample batch file. Let's say open. And now I need to select the name of a Pi data archive to which I want to send the data to. So in our case, it is Pi SRV1. Let's choose that and say OK. Based upon whatever settings were there in the sample batch file, interface configuration utility for this instance is populated with the necessary values. So there is something important, which is point source. Let's retain the same as OPC. Interface ID can remain the same as 1. And I would like to just briefly point you to an important attribute called API hostname. In this one, we note that the name of the Pi data archive is indicated by the hostname. But it could also be represented with an IP address as well as fully qualified domain name as well. This will come up again when we start discussing about buffering mechanism. The next item which we can talk about is adding scan classes. So right now we have 4 scan classes, and if you want to add more, you can add it as well. But in our case, we will leave it as it is. Next, we want to configure the OPC server. So right now, our OPC server, we know that resides on the same node, so localhost is fine, but we need to populate it with the name of the OPC server. Here. So click on list available servers, and let's select OPC sample dot OPCDA 20 server.1. Let's click save so that we can save the settings. And if you want to know what are the things which are there, let's go back again to the OPC client, which is we have on our desktop. Let's say run as administrator. And if I explore all the OPC servers, and this is the one which is there, which we are going to use. Kindly note that we are not going to be covering DCOM in this online course, though there is a separate user manual for configuring DCOM that can be downloaded from OSIsoft tech support website. Now, let's do the final step, namely to create the Windows service for the OPCDA interface. To do that, click on service, and then click on domain/username. Now, we need to make sure that the interface is going to be running under a specific domain service account. We have a domain service account which is called Pi Interface Service AC. First, we need to type in the name of the domain, Pi School, slash the name of the account. And we need to type in the password and confirm the password. and then click on the Save button at the top. And then we create the Windows service by clicking on the Create button. Now we can click on the Apply button at the bottom. At this time, we have completely configured the Pi interface for OPC DA, and we can start the Windows service. So before we start any interface instance, it's always a good practice to open up the logs. So click on the Pi get message logs. Now let's go and start the interface by clicking on the Start button. We can see the messages coming in. So let's go over the messages. So these are the contents of our batch file. It has established successful connection to the Pi Data Archive, which is PySRV1. It has successfully connected to our OPC server. And finally, it has queried for the list of Pi tags, which belongs to the point source OPC. And currently, we have not configured any Pi point, so the number is 0. In summary, in this video, we understood the steps involved in creating an instance of the Pi interface for OPC DA. Now, the next step would be to create and configure Pi tags so that the Pi interface can operate on it to collect the data from the OPC server and historize the data in the Pi Data Archive.